Here's a very quick update on the state of the project. In the last video, I talked at great length about using the AX signal as backpressure, having a module with a 75 MHz run at 1 MHz. I also talked about how wait states, i.e. the hardware not being ready with the answers, will be taken into account. Those led me to an important realization. Someone needs to implement backpressure and wait states in my design. Following the TDD paradigm, the first step is to add backpressure to the test bench. That didn't turn out to be very complicated. I added a counter that counts cycles and tied the AX signal to it. The result is that most transactions are halted by the computer and the CPU has to wait to perform them. I also added a check that the requests don't change while the CPU is waiting. As expected, at this point the CPU failed to execute the code, but eventually I got the CPU to run the test program, start to finish, in a bus accurate wait. Next came the wait state support. Again, I changed the test bench to wait before providing data being read. So now, we need to make sure that if the CPU is waiting for an answer, it will not change state until it actually receives it. This was a little more complicated as the condition depends on something that happened in the previous cycles, but I did eventually manage to make the CPU pass all tests again. And with that, the 6502, at least for the MOS variant, is done. Let me just take this opportunity to mention how powerful a good test infrastructure is. Because my test bench is so exhaustive, I finished the whole thing, including changing the test bench itself, in a single weekend. For reference, preparing this video took much longer. So that's it for now. On to integrating the 6502 with a 32-bit RISC. Thank you for watching.